IQ is a unique blend of 3 and 6.
Oh, tell us about that, because there's also this whole controversy around the ratios.
Absolutely.
Between 3 and 6, and do we need 9? Please tell us a bit more about
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely. So if we went back to the caveman, the cave dweller, to Adam, and we looked at...
That's a long way back.
That's a very long way back.
Can we remember that far back? We need a whole bottle of this.
But I think you actually really need to get down to the nitty-gritty of where the beginning started. Our bodies, as we are born, are meant to be born within perfect homeostatic environment. But because of our behavior and our environment and different habits, that changes over time. In the days of back then, when we were taking in the perfect amount of 3 and 6, the ratio was 1 to 1.
Okay.
So for every 1 omega-6 we took in, we took 1 omega-3. So the pro-inflammatory mediator was omitted by the anti-inflammatory mediator of the
perfect
two.
Perfect balance.
So you had perfect balance. Today, Western culture has completely gone in the wrong direction, and because of a lot of reasons, we're not able to grow food as organically. We are very dependent on fast food or convenience foods for our families. The increase of saturated fats is exponentially grown, and those are very rich in omega-6s, and these omega-6s in excess, arachidonic acid, which is a very powerful pro-inflammatory mediator, can actually cause disease. So when
you're talking about a poor diet of
a really poor diet. So if you look at Western, right now, Western living people, our ratio of omega-3 to 6 is 1 to 20.
What?
So if you can imagine, the ratio is completely out of balance, and that is why there's been this definite upsurge of popularity in trying to recreate that balance by increasing your omega-3 intake, both through diet, and if you can't eat that many fish or algae or whichever source you choose, to actually go and take a supplement.
So tell me about the omega-6 part of the ratio.
So the omega-6 part of the ratio in IQ is an omega-6 called GLA. GLA we source from evening primrose oil. Evening primrose oil is used for a plethora of conditions to assist and support and prevent.
Also called safflower oil.
Well, it can be sourced from safflower. It can be sourced from many, many plant sources. Ours is sourced from evening primrose oil. And the GLA and IQ is actually there to create a little bit of a balance, because you can't just increase your omega-3 uptake. You really do need to look after that other component. And GLA actually is prevents any of the omega-3 from being converted to omega-6.
Yes.
So it is there to prevent the conversion between pro-inflammatory, anti-inflammatory to pro-inflammatory.
And that's when you really need to understand when you're formulating a brand.
Yes.
And for people to know, don't just go and take an omega-3 supplement on its own.
Yeah. And also an excess of omega-3, you're going to get an upregulation again of the one. And then there's a consequence of that as well.
Sure.
So it's always about the balance.